Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a comparison video amongst these two micellar waters. This one is the Garnier micellar water, all-in-one normal and sensitive skin. This is, I believe, the original one that it first came out with. This one, on the other hand, is the Etude House Monster micellar cleansing water. So it's kind of like the West versus the East, you know, kind of battle. I'm gonna start off with talking about this one. So I got this at my local drugstore. It retails for about $10 Canadian. I got it for $8 because it was on sale at the time, so yay me, right, for sales. and this one is 400 milliliters. It comes in a bottle where you just open the cap and you kind of just like pour it on a cotton pad kind of thing, so you get to adjust how much product you want to pour out. On the other hand, this is the Etude House Monster micellar water. This one is about 700 milliliters. I did get the value one. This one retails off their Etude House website for $16.80 US. At that time, I had a 50% off, I guess, discount, so I got this for half the price. So it was like $8.40 US, so I would say about like roughly $10 to $11 Canadian. So, you know, I think value wise this is pretty good, right, considering you get 700 milliliters versus 400 right here. And unfortunately, this one is only offered, the Garnier one is only offered in this size, and they have a travel one for 125 milliliters. This one, on the other hand, has a smaller version, which is, I guess, more equivalent to this one, for 300 milliliters, but it retails for about $13.80, I believe, US. And they also have a travel size one too, which is, I think, also 125 milliliters. So yeah, so just to give you guys an idea of like where you can purchase this. I got this at my local drugstore. I got this one off the Etude House website. I believe you can buy it off like Amazon as well, and same with other maybe Korean makeup store websites online. Versus this one, I can get it at my local drugstore, which convenience-wise, I would say this is way more convenient than getting this. So if I run out of this last minute, I can just like go out to a drugstore and pick that up, right? For pretty much $10. Value-wise, of course, I think the micellar water from Etude House has a better value, and the fact that I love how they have a pump. Regardless of these two types of designs, you cannot refill the bottle anyhow, so after when you finish it, unfortunately, you will have to recycle it because it's a plastic. But yeah. Anyhow, so I'm gonna test out both of these with like makeup on the back of my hands and show you guys whether which one works better. I have used both of these for a good period of time. So I'm gonna swatch the back of my hands with an eyeliner that I would normally use, you know, mascara that I normally use, and of course some kind of lippy, which I normally use as well. So I'm gonna start off with the Garnier micellar water. I just kind of pour it onto a cotton pad like I normally do. I find that a bottle like this, I tend to like pour more than maybe I necessarily need all at once, because it's so much easier to like just pour it. So this is on the back of my hands, and let me see. Oh, very well. This is only one swipe, and I would say it got off majority of the makeup. And this is just 2, 3, 4, 5. I would say about 6, because this is kind of like a waterproof eyeliner. It's a liquid eyeliner, and it did a pretty good job. And I have to say, like, I've used this many times, and there is no like residue that it leaves behind. It feels very clean. I love using it like pretty much right after when I use a makeup remover. Like, this would be like something to catch the remaining residue from the makeup remover. And there are days where I run out of the makeup remover and I go straight to this, and I have to say I do really like it. I just pour more than I normally would and actually wipe everything off my face. Okay, now comparing it to the Etude House Monster one, I'm gonna do the same thing. Put on like swatches of an eyeliner, a mascara, and of course starts a lippy. I always find lippies are the easiest to wipe off because most of my lippies that I use, I don't use like a liquid one or a permanent one. And then because I'm going to test this out, it's literally you just pump. I usually do like 3 or 4 times, or 3 times usually, sorry. And you know, you get sufficient amount. I wouldn't say it would be as much as this because this one you can easily pour way too much. And let's see. Oh, same thing. Right, that's only one swatch, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This one, I have to say, like I've noticed this actually the first few times that I've used it, which is it is a little bit harder to remove waterproof makeup. I know some people think it's fine because you just kind of just rub it a few more times or something like that, especially if you have like waterproof mascara. I find this one leaves a tiny little bit of residue. Like I still feel like I need to like at least wipe my face with, you know, just clear, just water to get off that residue. But I have to say it doesn't bug me. Both of these are not scented in any way. But I have to say this one, because bang for your buck, I will go with this one. But I will not use this with, if I ran out of like makeup wipes and just use this and don't do a double cleanse. This one, on the other hand, I would say is fine. I don't need to do a double cleanse. I just have to use a little bit more than I normally would. But bang for your buck, I have to say, yes, I would go with this one and just use this as more of like, removing the rest of the residue. I use this more for my lips, the lip part, because I find like, oh, okay, it's nice and soft and gentle. I would use it for this one as well, but not so much as this one, because I also feel like with a pump, I love the pump part. So I wouldn't even go with, I think the smaller bottle of this doesn't have a pump. So that was the reason why I went for the, you know, the better value of it. So that's that. And yeah, so in comparison to both of these, they both have their pros and cons, I would have to say. But for convenient wise and, you know, the fact that, yes, I do need to pay a little bit more, I would say the Garnier one is my choice. But at the same time, if, you know, I'm going for value and the fact that I don't mind there's a tiny little bit of residue and that it doesn't really, really get off like waterproof makeup, but it does its job like it says it does, then I will go for the Etude House Monster one. Anyhow, that's the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and if so, remember to give me that thumbs up. I do try to upload weekly videos now, like it's a little bit harder for me to do 1 to 2, so do check back next week for a new video, and of course, subscribe to my channel and turn on that little bell for notification. I shall see you guys in my next one. Bye!